Friends, welcome to my channel Dev's Institute. Today we will see stepper motor program. This is problem statement. Write ALP to interface 8051 with stepper motor to rotate motor with different step angles and speed. So before going towards actual program, first we will see what is stepper motor, what it consists of, how it rotates, and how to find out its step angles. So this is a basic diagram of a stepper motor, which consists of a rotor at the center and surrounded by the stator. Here we have used the four stator design diagram. So stator is basically an electromagnet, a magnet which has a coil. So when current is applied through this coil, then and then only the magnetic fields of the magnet will be active. And this is rotor. Rotor is nothing but the simple magnet which consists of two poles. Here, for simplicity, I have named the stators as A, B, C and D. Stator A and B are connected by a common wire. Similarly, stator C and D are connected by a common wire. So when current is passed through this A, side A or stator A, the magnetic field of A as well as B will be active. But later on, if we disconnect current from here and if we apply current from the direction of B, that is from B to A, at that time when the direction of current will change, the polarities will be reversed. We'll see this in detail with the help of examples. So first we'll see how full step sequence works, or how to find out the full step sequence. So these are the four stators A, B, C. So, in full step sequence, we perform four steps to complete one rotation. That is, in each rotation, the rotor rotates through 90 degree angle. Okay, so here initially, we'll make current flow through A and C. So, A and C will be 1 and B and D will be 0. So, A is 1. B is 0, C is 1 and D is 0. 1, 0, 1, 0. So, by applying this current, this south pole, this north pole and this north pole are active now. Okay. So, this rotor will be equally attracted by this south pole and this south pole. Similarly, this south pole is equally attracted by this north pole and this north pole. As a result, the position of rotor will be like this, because it is equally attracted by these two south poles. Similarly, this end is equally attracted by these two north poles. In next cycle, we'll make C and B 1. So, our next sequence will be 0, 1, 1, 0. B and C are 1. B and C are 1. So now here we have applied current at B. So the direction of the current is changed. Initially it was, earlier it was from A to B, and now we have applied current. Now we have disconnected current from here and we have applied current from B. As the direction of current is changed, this polarities will be reversed. This will remain same, because earlier also it was from C to D and now also it is from C to D. So these polarities will be same. These polarities will be reversed. So this N will become S and this S will become N. Okay. So now, because of this, now this south pole will be repelled by this this south pole will be repelled by this south pole, and this south pole will be attracted by these two north pole. Similarly, this north pole will be attracted by these two south pole. So the position of rotor will be like this. at a third cycle, we'll make B and D 1. So B and D are 1, A and C are 0. So this will remain as it is, and direction of this current will change from C to D. Earlier it was, and now it will be D to C. So D to C. So polarity of these two magnets will change. This will become S, this will become N. So now again this S will repel. It will be attracted equally by this N and this N. So the position of the rotor will be like this. Now we'll make A and D 1. So A and D 1 again. So this will be A and D 1. So the direction of A has changed. So these polarities will change. And now rotor will rotate like this. So this has completed one rotation of the rotor. Four steps. Full step. So this will result in steps. After this, so this is A and D. After this, we'll make A and C 1. So that is nothing but the first step. So again, our rotor will come to the first step. So this sequence is nothing but A 6 5 9. So this results in a full step sequence. In each step, rotor rotates through 90 degree angle. So now what if we want half step sequence? So in half steps, we require total 8 steps to complete one rotation, and it will be 45 degree angle at each step. So for half step sequence, what we'll do? First will be as it is, both A and C will be on. So position of the rotor will be like this. Then at second step, we'll completely disconnect this current and we'll only apply current at C. So it will be only C1. So A is 0, B is 0, D is 0 and C is 1. That will be 0, 2. So this and this are inactive as current is not applied at B, A or B. So this and this are inactive. So this is south and this is north. So your rotor will be exactly at horizontal position. Earlier it was like this and now it is like this. Means it has only rotated through 45 degree. In next step, again we'll make C and B both on. C and B on. So position of rotor will be like this. After this, we'll disconnect this and we'll apply only current at B, means which is already present. So it will be all zeros, only B is 1. All zeros, only B is 1. So the position of rotor will be like this. In next step, it will be B and D on. So position will be like this. In next, only D will be on. So it will be like this. At next, A and D will be on. And after that, only A will be on. So this is a half step sequence where in each step, rotor only rotates through 45 degree angle, and number of steps required for complete rotation are 8. In full step sequence, it requires 4 rotations, and in half step sequence, it requires 8 steps. Okay. To complete one rotation. Now the sequence which we have discussed is a clockwise sequence. We have seen now the rotor rotates in clockwise direction. If you apply this sequence in reverse order, it will be anti-clockwise. So simply we have to apply first 8, then 9, then 1, 5, 4, 6, 2, A. So this will be our anti-clockwise. And similarly, in full step sequence, if you apply 9, means if you first make A and B on, then D and B on, then next cycle B and C on, then next cycle C and A on. That means 9, 5, 6, A. It will be anti-clockwise direction rotation. So this is about half step sequence and full step sequence. So now we know how to find out the step sequence, and now we'll see the actual program. So here in this program, first three statements are related to setting up the control word register. We all are aware of control word register. If you want to know about control word register, then please visit my video related to waveform generation program. There you will get details of control word register format and how to set control word register. Okay, so here first three instructions. So from here stepper motor program will start. Move a comma at hash ath. So simply it will move at hex value to accumulator. Move dptr comma hash 103h. So we are moving address 103 hex into dptr. We all know that dptr is a data pointer register, which is 16 bit register, which is used to store the address. Then move x at the rate dptr comma a. So simply it will move this ath value to 103. Now what is 103? 103 address is a address for control word register. So in short, ath means we have initialized control word register for IO mode, that is input output mode, and all ports, port A, port B, port C, upper, lower, all ports of 8255 are set as output mode. Okay, so in short, now we know what is control word register. If you want it in detail, you can visit my video on waveform generation program. The next is move dptr comma 100h. 100h is the address of port A. So now we are going to send data through port A to the stepper motor. So we have 8255 connected with stepper motor. So 8255's port A will send data to stepper motor, and stepper motor will work accordingly. So 100H is the address of port A, which is connected to stepper motor. Okay, so this is our full step sequence, which we have studied just now, A, 6, 5, 9. So to port A, we are going to send first A, then we are going to call delay, then we'll send 6, then again we'll call delay, then we'll send 5, then we'll call delay, and then we'll send 9 and we'll call delay, and again the process is repeated. Okay, so we have purposefully introduced delay in this program so that we can observe the steps carefully. Okay, so these three statements are related to initializing control word register. Then move dptr comma 100h. So we have moved address of port A into the dptr. So now move a comma 0ah, that is the first sequence. We have moved to accumulator, and from accumulator we have moved it to the memory address 100. We cannot move directly data to the memory address. First we have to move data to accumulator, and from accumulator we can move it to the memory address. So first we have moved this A into accumulator, and from accumulator we have moved it to memory address, and then we have called delay. So simply this port A will send 0A value to the stepper motor, and our stepper motor will perform the first step operation. That means our stepper motor or our rotor will rotate in a first, means it will lie according to this value 0A. Then next we'll send 06 to the port A. So again 06 is moved to accumulator. From accumulator it has been moved to 100H, that is port A. Again delay is called. Then next we'll send 5U to accumulator. From accumulator it will be sent to 100H. Again delay is called, and move A comma 9H. Again delay is called, and then L jump up. L jump up means it will go again here and it will repeat this entire sequence again. A 6 5 9, again L jump up. A 6 5 9. So that stepper motor will be continuously running in the clockwise direction. If you want anti-clockwise direction, just you have to pass these values in reverse order. Means first you will pass 9, then 5, then 6, then A. Okay. So this is all about the program. Here is the delay routine. So at one memory location, let's consider C00, you will write this program. And let's say you are writing delay at D00, so you will write simply here L call D00. That's it. So delay routine, move R1, 06H, move R2, FFH, DJNZ R2, up 1. That is a decrement and jump if not 0. What? R2. So decrement R2, decrement contents of register R2. So FF will be decremented by 1, and if it is not 0, jump to up one means at this line only, at this instruction only. Again decrement, if not 0, jump here. Again decrement, if not 0, jump here. So this instruction will be executed till this R2 value becomes 0. When that R2 value becomes 0, the control will come to next instruction. Decrement and jump, if not 0, R1 up 2. So what is R1 now? 6. So this 6 will be decremented by 1. It will become 5. And jump to up 2. Since it will go here and again initialize R2. So this is, in normal programming language, we can call it as just for within for. So just we have introduced delay here, and when this delay procedure is complete, so both these values, when both these values become 00, it will execute return. Return means it will return to the function from where, or the instruction from where it was called. So if it is called from here, it will return here, and then it will execute this again, the delay will be called. So this is all about the stepper motor program. I hope you have understood the program, you have understood the concept of stepper motor. Thank you very much for watching my video. I hope you are liking my videos. If you like my video, press like button given below the video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and if you have any queries, feel free to ask it through comment section. Thank you very much.